Good morning. Welcome to Holy Spirit Parish. Today is, we're celebrating the Annunciation of the Lord. Our Mass intention is for Chuck Schlarp. Please rise for the Regina Caeli. Queen of Heaven, rejoice. Alleluia. The Son whom you were privileged to bear, alleluia, has risen as he said, alleluia. Pray for us to God, alleluia. Rejoice and be glad, O Virgin Mary, alleluia. For the Lord has truly risen, alleluia. Let us pray. O God, it was by the resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, that you brought joy to the world. Grant that through the intercession of the Virgin Mary, his mother, we may attain the joy of eternal life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The St. Michael Prayer. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join in singing number 893, Mary First Among Believers, 893. We'll do verses 1 and 3 and 5 if needed.
Mary, first among believers, trusting in the angel's word, you consented. Conceiving, brought to birth the Son of God. Mother, now of all believers, give our fragile faith increase. May we trust in fears release. Mary, first among disciples, listening, learning from your Son. You held dear his words and actions, pondering each for follow Jesus' way. Mary, first among the blessed, robed in heaven's beauty bright, you rejoice with saints and angels in your Son's resplendent light. Mother, now of all the blessed, make your pilgrim people strong. Keep us faithful till we join you, praising God song.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your
should take on the reality of human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary. Grant, we pray, that we who confess our Redeemer to be God and man may merit to become partakers even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld, or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David, is it not enough for you to weary people? Must you also weary my God? Therefore the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And victim. Then I said, see, I have come. Here am I, Lord. Here am I, Lord. I come to do your will. In the scroll of the book, it stands written of me. I delight to do your will, O my God. Your instruction lies deep within me. Here am I, Lord. Here am I, Lord. I come. Your justice I have proclaimed in the great assembly. My lips I have not sealed. You know it, O Lord. Here am I, Lord. Here am I, Lord. I come. Saving help I have not hidden in my heart. Of your faithfulness and salvation I have spoken. I made no secret of your merciful love and your faithfulness to the great assembly. Here am I. I come to do your will.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, it is impossible that the blood of bulls and goats takes away sins. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocausts and sin offerings you took no delight." Then I said, as is written of me in the scroll, "Behold, I come to do your will, O God." First he says, "Sacrifices and offerings, holocausts and sin offerings, you neither desired nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law." Then he says, "Behold, I come to do your will." He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
of God became flesh and made his dwelling among us, and we saw his glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. The words of the gospel. May our sins be wiped away.
We certainly want to welcome everybody here this afternoon as we participate in the Mass of the Feast of the Annunciation. And as we gather here today, why do we do it today instead of on March 25th? Well, whenever it falls during Holy Week or the octave of Easter, then we have to move this feast day to beyond the octave of Easter, which today is day number 9, since we would celebrate Easter Sunday. Now you may wonder, why are there two priests here? Plus we have our deacon who often comes, and our server. Why? Because actually there's a reason for this. Initial intention, Mass intention today is for Chuck Schlarp, which Father Ben will take care of in his prayers. But we're also gathered here. We have members of the staff here today, which we appreciate their presence, to pray for Kathy Gabriel, one of our staff members, in faith formation, who will be undergoing surgery for her health, quite serious, we might say, but that's why we pray, and that's why we appreciate the presence of a staff as well as everybody else who's here as we pray not only for Chuck Schlarp but for Kathy Gabriel for her health and well-being and such through this surgery. Now, interestingly enough, We say, well, we have two Mass intentions. We also, kind of like Father Ben and I, made a deal in one sense. He says, well, since he likes to use incense, and fittingly so on a feast day, well then, let him be a celebrant, okay? Plus, I already had morning Mass for a funeral this morning, and then I thought, well, then I'll do the preaching. So as we gather here today then, we think about what does this feast mean? At a very basic level, we can, if we use mathematics, trying to figure out what we're actually celebrating here, because sometimes people may be confused. So the Feast of the Annunciation is, as we heard, that Blessed Mother Mary has a message from the angel that she is to be the Mother of God through the power of the Most High, so that she would conceive our Savior Jesus Christ, the Son of God, our Savior, Lord. So when you think about it, March 25th, if we would have gone with the original day of March 25th, 9 months later, we get to what? December 25th. So the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ, if we strictly go by the nine-month aspect of it all. Now, we also want to compare this to, but it's different, because sometimes people think about Immaculate Conception, December 8th. What's that all about? It's actually about the conception of Mary in the womb of her mother, okay? So that 9 months later, the birthday of Mary is September 8th. So this feast is all about how Jesus was conceived in the womb of Mary. And so that's why then we look to 9 months later to celebrate Christmas. Immaculate Conception has to do with Mary, and then her birthday, September 8th. But once now that we have that taken care of, and I'm sure you'll remember this for the rest of your life, and you can spread it on to other people, well then we think about how wonderful our Blessed Lady was able to be willing to do the will of God, even though she didn't quite understand everything that goes into doing the will of God. That would be very similar to those who are about to get married. You take a leap of faith. You know, you say, yes, I believe I'm called to be with this person, and then to live the rest of my life in fidelity with this person. A leap of faith, if you will. Do you know everything about it? Do you understand everything? If anybody does, well, then see me after Mass. But I would suspect that most people probably take a leap of faith, and they said, yes, Lord, I will take this man to be my spouse or this woman to be my spouse, okay? So it could be very similar in priesthood and religious life. Do we actually know what's happening? No. At least I can say for myself, we have an idea. We believe we're called, we're prompted, but we say, Lord, I've come to do your will. We've come to do the will of God. We don't understand all the aspects of it, just like how can parents have an exercise and train to be parents? There's no parent class out there. We go to seminary as priests to learn about things that happen with theology and spirituality and sacraments. But again, living the day-to-day, it's a leap of faith. You know, we put faith in God. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. That's what we do. That's what it's all about. Mary is the great example of what it is to trust in God. She was a young girl. What's going on here? She is not in any intimate relationship with Joseph or anybody for that matter, and yet somehow she believes and trusts. Yesterday we celebrated Divine Mercy Sunday, huh? What is that famous expression? I trust in you. I trust in you. Well, Mary trusted in God, in God's plan. And thank God she did, because then that's why we have our Savior who is born, and he not only was born, and I usually say that it's wonderful that we could celebrate Christmas, but we celebrate Christmas a 12-day season. But if Jesus didn't do anything to help us on our road to salvation, well then why would we celebrate? But to get to the point of Easter, then, where he did the work of accomplishing our salvation. That's why we celebrate Easter for 50 days, and it's wonderful. So we could probably say Happy Easter, Christ is risen again to everybody, and let's not forget that it's a 50-day season. But as we continue then, and we celebrate this Feast of Annunciation, we have to ask ourselves too, What kind of message is God asking us or delivering to us? Are we heeding the message? Message of repentance? Is the world heeding the message of repentance, of what it is for us to do the will of God, not our own will, because when we do our own will, it may not be right. It may not be right in God's eyes. But do we submit, to surrender to God's will, to do what is right, to follow his commands? Well, then indeed we are blessed. And so the ultimate person of doing the will of God is Jesus himself. Okay, but Mary is a reflection of Jesus in the sense of saying yes. Jesus says yes to be our Savior. Mary says yes to be the mother of our Savior. And so can we be more yes people to God's will? Can the world be doing a better job? Of course. And so we gather here and we say, help us, Blessed Mother Mary, intercede for us, that we might not be stubborn of heart, that we might not be people that want to do our own thing at our own convenience, but sometimes we have to, a lot of times we have to submit ourselves to the will of God. Now, interestingly enough, as we celebrate this Feast of the Assumption today on April 8th, this happens to be the day where this solar eclipse is supposed to be happening, and you know, I just want to sort of like add a little bit to that to see if there's some kind of spiritual significance to what this may be all about. And we could take it from here. But the eclipse is a reminder of God's perfect, intricate creation of which we are a part. As we take in the upcoming eclipse, which supposedly is to happen this afternoon, mid-afternoon, the coming together of the sun and the moon, of course, with our protected eyes, hopefully, our hearts will take in the coming of God and man, which, of course, occurred on the Annunciation. So the coming together of the sun and the moon, our hearts prepare, as we think about this Annunciation, the coming together of God and man, okay? Now, Mary is a true reflection of Jesus, who is the light of the world, okay? And so now people will see, hopefully, a partial solar eclipse followed by a brief total solar eclipse during which it's supposed to be dark. Now, on the day when the moon will pass between the sun and the earth, casting a shadow on a pathway through North America during the middle of this afternoon, well, interestingly enough, from a spiritual dimension, we could say the church remembers how the Holy Spirit overshadowed a young Virgin Mary in Nazareth, beginning a specific course of events that would change the world. On a day when simultaneously we give thanks to Jesus Christ for his mother's yes and experience an awesome celestial event during this hopeful season of Easter, may we realize that we have to be people who say yes to God's will in our living so we can step out of darkness into the light. Eclipses have occurred in the history of Israel, my friends in Christ, where God has sent the message of repentance and conversion of sins either against God or against Israel. Now, darkness conveys a sign of perhaps of sin and wrongdoing. So the eclipse will render darkness at a given time of the day. We are all, if we take a look at this from a spiritual dimension, to repent from the darkness of our sins so that we can live in the light of God's love. We are to turn to the light, who is Jesus. Jesus is the ultimate light of the world. And may we, when we look at, not that we look at the sun, but the sun perhaps helps us to realize of the light, Jesus who is the light. So taking this all together then, my friends in Christ, may we always realize what the darkness of our world is, what the darkness of our sins are, but then we realize that we are to be people of the light, that we are to always draw to the light, that we are to go away from darkness back into the light. And who's going to help us with this? Of course, Jesus, who is the light of the world, who is also going to help us in a most wonderful way, the greatest of all the saints, Mary, our Blessed Mother. That's why we have great devotion to her And just remember this, that we pray through her. Sometimes people say, oh, I pray to the Blessed Mother, or I pray to the saints. Please change that, okay? Because we pray through the Blessed Mother to Jesus, The power of God, it comes from God, and its Blessed Mother is the vehicle through whom we pray to Jesus. May God be with us. May God bless us all.
Father Aaron mentioned the connection of today's feast with that of the Nativity of our Lord at Christmas. This is the other of the 2 days of the year in which, during the profession of faith, we are called to kneel at the words, "And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man." And so together we now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit,
for our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Grateful for the great gift that we have in Jesus' incarnation, recognizing that in our own lives we ought to reflect Mary's willingness to serve our Lord, we now present to our Heavenly Father these our prayers.
For the Church and her mission of announcing the good news throughout the world, may God continue to bless and sustain this holy work of evangelization. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected officials, may the Lord grant them the fortitude to remain true to his justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married couples who struggle with infertility, may God give them consolation and hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who worship here, may the Holy Spirit help us more firmly embrace our faith in a loving God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the ill and those who have health concerns, especially Kathy Gabriel, that God will grant them good health and that God will bless all health care providers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have passed away in the light of faith, especially Chuck Schlarp, may God bring them to everlasting life in him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those special petitions unverbalized that remain written in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us conclude our petitions with our parish prayer. Lord Jesus, you told us where your treasure is, there your heart is also. The parish of Holy Spirit treasures our faith in you, our children, and every person who gathers here. Help us to have the courage to sacrifice, to love, to build in your name. Guide us by your spirit of wisdom. Give success to the work of our hands and keep us in your peace. Saints, martyrs, and Mary, our mother, pray for us.
Please join in singing number 895, O Most Holy One, 895.
Refuge in our fears.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of God's holy church.
Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your church's offering, so that she, who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son, may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that the Christ was to be born among men, and for men's sake by the overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit. Lovingly she bore him in her immaculate womb, that the promises to the children of Israel might come about, and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Oh. mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you in your compassion, O merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace to you, brother. Peace to you, brother God.
On you stay, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 891, Ave Maria, 891. Our death.
Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
You heard Father Aaron mention that there is, starting around 2 o'clock, I think, a solar eclipse. I said to everyone yesterday at Mass, this is not to put forth the assumption that any of you are stupid, but there will be stupid people on the road. My priest friend called me this morning. I said, what are you doing? He said, oh, you know, I'm driving around looking up at the sun. I say that in humor, but one of the cautions that is voiced is there are people who are not going to be thinking, who will be driving around looking to see the eclipse and will not be paying attention to the road. They always make an announcement. If you are driving anywhere this afternoon between about 2 and 3:30 or 4 o'clock, just be careful. And the other one is, if you don't have protective stuff, do not look at the sun. And that might sound ridiculous, but it bears repeating, because every year there are people, when there's an eclipse, who burn their eyes out because they think, well, it's almost not there. Almost not there is still a lot of light, so don't do that either. But just in all seriousness, please be safe if you're out driving around, because you might not be, but there will be stupid people on the road, okay? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of her through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life.
Amen. Amen.
May you, who have devoutly gathered on this day, carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 949. Alleluia, sing to Jesus, 949.